Good morning. Today is the third video of for the exercise 19A. We will see some few more questions of exercise 19A where we are trying to learn writing the equation of straight lines in different conditions, right? You already now know that there are three different forms of linear equation of a straight line. One is the slope and intercept form. The formula is y is equal to mx plus c. Another is one slope and one point, for which we are using the formula y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. And the third formula we use when we have the coordinate of two points, and the formula we are using is y minus y1 is equal to y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1 into x minus x1. So these are the three formulas. Today I am telling you verbally because in the previous two classes I have shown you on the board. So now you should be able to connect with me what I am saying, isn't it? So with this we will see some few more simple questions. Now we will start with question number 9. Can you look at the board? Question number 9. In question number 9 we have four part, but then I will teach you the two part, clear? And the other two part will be your assignment. It's very simple. Question number 9, part A. Write down the slope of the line. We are asked to find out the slope, and then you know, like slope, you can find out in two different ways. I have shown you both the ways. One method is by writing the equation in the slope and y intercept form, that is y is equal to mx plus c. So if you write down the equation in the form of slope and y intercept form, you are able to get the slope. Another method I told you was by writing all the terms in one side, on the left hand side, and right hand side should be zero, right? By writing the equation in this format also, we are able to write the slope. And then if you are writing all the terms on left hand side and right hand side is zero, then the method by which we write the slope is equal to minus the coefficient of x in the numerator divided by coefficient of y in the denominator. Now when we are writing the coefficient of x in the numerator and the coefficient of x in the denominator, we write these terms with their sign. Clear? I repeat, I'll show you. Suppose if you have your equation written all the terms in one side, ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. You wrote all the terms in one side and right hand side is 0. By writing the equation in this format also, we are able to write the slope. So in that case, how do we write the slope? Is we write the slope by writing minus sign. Minus sign is independent of all this, right? Has no link with this all, right? Whether they are positive or negative, in the formula there is minus sign. And then you write the coefficient of x in the numerator and coefficient of x in the denominator. This is also the slope. Am I very clear? So when we write this numerator and the denominator, when we write these coefficients, we have to write with their sign. Suppose if this is positive, we will write this a with positive. If this is negative, then we will write this a with a negative sign. Please don't connect that sign of these terms with this sign. They are separate. They are different. Am I very clear? So now in question number 9, we are asked to write the slope of the line. And for that, the condition is number A, we are given the coordinate of the two points. So the points are 1, 1. The coordinate of point P is 1, 1 and coordinate of point Q is 2, 3. Clear? So you know that now, since we have a coordinate of two points, we will be able to write down the equation. So after writing the equation, then we have to write down the slope. So let us write the equation first of all. Okay, this we will assume as x1, y1. This is 2.4, and this will be x2, y2, and then the slope, then the equation. So equation will be y minus y1, that is 1, is equal to y2 minus y1, y2 minus y1, 3 minus 1, 3 minus 1 divided by x2 minus x1, 2 minus 1, 2 minus 1 into x minus x1, that is 1. Clear? Now simplify. 3 minus 1 is 2. 2 minus 1 is 1. And then x minus 1. Simplify now. This 1 denominator we don't have to do anything, we can just ignore it. Simply multiply 2 by x and minus 1. And this is as it is, y minus 1 is equal to 2x minus 2. Clear? Now, we can write all the terms in one side. So, this is 2x minus y. This is minus 2. When this minus 1 comes to this side, is plus 1 is equal to 0. This is 2x minus y minus 1 is equal to 0. Now your equation is in this format. I am not writing this equation in the slope and y-intercept. If you want, you can please write down this equation in the slope and y-intercept form. You write in any form, your answer will be same. So in this format, the slope will be m will be equal to negative sign. Now the coefficient of x, that is 2, and then the coefficient of y, that is minus 1. Minus 1, this is equal to minus minus cancel, answer is 2. So this is your answer. Am I understood or not? I will show you. By writing the equation in this format, you got the slope. But if you, some of you may like to write this equation in the slope and y-intercept form. So if you write this in the slope and y-intercept, how, what will be the answer? What will be the slope? Let us see that. So here I will write this as y is equal to, y will be taken out, because your slope and y-intercept form is y is equal to mx plus c. So y will be separated. So y is taken to right side. The rest will be on the same side. So it will be 2x minus 1. Clear? So now this equation is written in the form of slope and y-intercept form. And from here, we can write down the slope. And if you have your equation in the slope and y-intercept form, then the slope will be the coefficient of x. So this is the answer. Are these two answers same? So whether you write this way or you write this way, it is choice is yours. Am I very clear? Alright. Now, here itself, I will take question number C. Question number C is what? Look at the board. Parallel to the line joining this. You have to find the slope of the line which is parallel to the line you get by joining the two points. So the two points are, first of all, A is negative 1 and 5. Clear? Another point is negative 6 and negative 7. Is this okay? Now, you will first of all write down the equation of this line. So y minus y1, 5 is equal to y2 minus y1, minus 7 minus 5, divided by x2 minus x1, minus 6 minus minus 1. When you are writing this, please be very, very mindful of the sign into x minus x1, that is minus 1 again. Now minus 7 and minus 5 is equal to minus 12, minus 12, divided by this minus minus plus. So minus 6 plus 1 is minus 5. Clear? And this is now x plus 1. Alright, this minus and this minus will be cancelled. Now cross multiply. 5 will be multiplying these two. So 5y minus 25 is equal to 12x plus 12. Now, how you want to do? Your wish. You want to write this in this format, writing all the terms in one side, or you want to write this in the slope and y-intercept form, choice is yours. I am going to follow this step only, okay? Because this step you have seen for several times. If I show you this step repeatedly, then maybe your doubts will be clear. So take it all on one side. Because alphabetically, first of all, we write the x term, minus 5y. Clear? And this will be going to that side, so that will become added. So plus 25 plus 12 will become 37 is equal to 0. So this becomes your equation. And now we can write down the slope. Write down the slope. So slope of this will be equal to minus sign. Slope, coefficient of x is 12 and coefficient of y is minus 5, minus 5. Now this minus minus cancel, so your final slope is m is equal to 12 over 5. This is the slope of your, this equation, this line, the line joining these two points. And because, and now you have to find out the slope of your line, that is m2. Since the two lines will write here, since the two lines here, this I will write here itself. M is equal to 12 over 5. Now, this is the slope of your line joining these two points, but then you have to find the slope of your line which is parallel to this line. And you know the condition for the lines to be parallel? Right here, since lines are parallel, therefore M1 will be equal to M2. And M1 you have calculated this one, so M2 also will be 12 over 5. This is your answer. Is this well understood? Thank you. Please pause the video and copy this question. Thank you. Now the next question is question number 10. Very simple question. Find the equation of the line joining the given point. Right? So let us take first of all question number. I will take question number B. Right? The coordinates are LAB. Right? And then another is coordinate of M point is BA. So these are the coordinates of your points. And now we have to find out the equation joining these two points. It's very simple, 2.4. The formula is y minus y1 is equal to y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1 into x minus x1. Clear? Now to start. This is a1, x1, y1, and this is x2, y2. So let us start putting the value. Y minus y1 is b, is equal to y2 minus y1, a minus b, and then x2 minus x1, b minus a, b minus a, and this is x minus x1, that is a. Is that okay? Now we will simplify. See, this is a minus b and this is b minus a. If these both were same in the same order, right, and with the same sign, then we would have cancelled, no? It is doable. What we can do is from one of these two, right, we will take out the minus sign common. See what happens. Y minus b is equal to minus sign, I am taking out common from the denominator. Numerator will remain as it is. From the denominator, if I take out the minus sign, the negative will become positive and the positive will become negative. So this minus a will become plus a, and this b will become negative, right? And this is as it is x minus a. What will happen? Now this will become same, so they will be cancelled. So you got this down now as y minus b is equal to minus x minus a. Now open the bracket and multiply with the sign. This is y minus b is equal to, sign will change because you outside you have minus sign. So this will become minus x and this will become plus a. Clear? Now write it all in one side. So minus x will come to left side, will become plus. This is plus y. This is minus b as it is. And this is plus, this is minus a because this also comes on this side. So this is equal to 0. And this becomes the equation of your line. So writing the equation when the two coordinates are given, when the coordinates of two points are given, is a very comfortable work. Am I clear? So this is this question. After this, we will have one more question. First of all, copy this, then we will have another question. Thank you.